Hi everybody, welcome back to Power Attack. My name is Paul, and this is Icey. This was a game that it looked vaguely interesting to me, and I waited for it to go on sale again before I bought it, because I'm cheap, gaming on a budget, and I missed the last sale because I'm slow. So we're gonna give it a whirl, we're gonna have a look, and if I like it, I'll play more. Okay. What are you? Press B, upgrade. Okay. Okay. This is a very odd. Okay. Oh. I don't know. Oh, I don't have money, so. Oh, it's just showing me that for the future, I guess. You know, oh, so this is an execution. Okay, so I'm getting two strong vibes from this. One, when an enemy attacks, right bumper to dash. Okay. Okay, whoop. Nice! Okay, what I was going to say, because I keep getting distracted because, you know, squirrel! Two things. I'm watching, as you may know, I watch my hardware on the other monitor, like how much CPU and GPU I'm using. And it's not using a bunch, but it looks like it would. Welcome to Silent Hell. Is that like Silent Hill? Itchy nose. So I'm vaguely... I'm vaguely impressed that the animation isn't actually- Oh, you're still alive, you son of a bitch. Ah, fuck yourself. It's not using as much as it looks like it would, is what I'm gonna say. And I could be totally off base. It has a very Mega Man X feel right now. But it's kind of floatier and a little bit more liberal with its hack and slash. It vaguely reminds me. Well, that's neat, of playing Zero in, like, Mega Man X5, which was one of the first ones I ever remember playing Zero. I know he was in, like, 2 or 3, but I played 5 before I played those. So, yeah, this, I mean, it feels good. Some of the animations are a bit janky, but way better than I could do. $24, I can't buy anything with $24, probably. I mean, you can tell it kind of, like, points. It looks like it's just stretching her sprite. Like... Oh! Oh, fuck me! A dick! Is that my most used phrase on, like, this show? Channel? Thing. Thing that I do. Eat a dick! I did the dodgy thing! Okay, so the charge attack reminds me vaguely of Ninja Gaiden, because you could press and hold Y, I think it was. Maybe you could do it as X as well, to do, like, super mega attacks. You done? I got an achievement. It says Trinity's Chains. Well, I assume by the fact that I can't jump that we're in, like, cutscene mode. What? Let me guess, he's gonna destroy the bridge? Like a dick? You could have animated that better. See, I keep waiting I understand that... I see. Huh, I see. Oh, it was just waiting for me to hit A. Fixed dot binary. Okay. Anyway, as I was saying, supposedly the announcer, narrator rather, is supposed to be rather sassy. And I'm supposed to ITM at your service. Note, a very small percentage of individuals may experience epileptic seizures when exposed to flashing lights in this environment. Contents of this experiment are not intended to insult or offend. Please do not take anything personally. So, is this supposed to just give flavor? Only one person... So this is single player, I guess that's what it's hinting at? Reserve rights to final entry... What? What was the point of that? Was that supposed to be kind of, okay. I was about to say, was that just supposed to be meta? And I remember hearing that this game was just very, very meta. Like, that weird old television screen warble we've got going on. God, it's annoying. What are we doing? I can't tell if we're just in a loop or not. Are you Kawaii of the Beholder? That's the name I'm using on Steam right now. Did you take off the mask? What mask? I'm gonna go with no, because I don't know. Do you perform or... Normally I would say no, but fuck with this channel, yes. We know me. I can't do it easy for this. Was that a tutorial? A tutorial? I seem to have offended it.
In the middle of a dark, quiet room...
Oh, it speaks English
filled
now.
...filled only by the sounds of humming machines, a figure floats, suspended.
The little eyeball thingy?
She, Icey,
nope.
Has no memories, no past. Memories to her are not important.
That's because she has none. They're important when you have them.
Her existence only serves one purpose. To kill Judas.
Is it because he killed Jesus? Oh, God, what was that?
That wicked devil... The bringer of the apocalypse. No matter how many difficulties or obstacles she will face, Icey understands that she must accomplish her mission.
So much death. So, what are we doing now, Ace?
Destroy Judas.
Destroy.
In the darkness, Icey awakes.
I'm just making fun of the fact he said destroy. I would have just said destroy. Hold Y to start game, pliss. We're doing it.
Icey has left the laboratory.
We did this!
She understands that as long as she follows the arrow, she will discover where Judas... Oh, more soldiers sent by Judas to stop Icey. Kill them!
Kill him! I have a feeling I'm gonna need to make good use of these executions just to keep a lot of health. I have to say, some of these executions are rather satisfying. Ah! I was about to say, I'm pressing the execution.
Icey reaches a quiet hill, illuminated by light dancing off of the lake below. She is at peace.
Am I? I'm barely violent right now. I mean, look at this. Is this something that somebody peaceful would do? There we go. I was struggling with my English. Haha, now I'm getting good at estimating the damage these things can take. Now, I wonder if I can tell it to do different... I keep seeming to do that one, which is... What the deuce? He's trying to double fist me. Ow! You bitch. Oh, I got dunked. Eat a dick?
There seems to be a console that will activate the photon bridge. Icey moves to activate it.
This is an interesting style. Pseudo comic book narration. I will say the attack animations are quite smooth, but like the idle animations do not feel nearly as smooth. I will say at least these grunts help me get my health, shield, whatever back up to full. And they look stylish. There we go.
A disgusting swamp rests, unmoving, in front of Icey. She must carefully jump across.
Okay, so I can't afford some things. Ooh, that looks good, but I can't afford it yet. Yeah. Ooh. That seems good, but I want the thing where I slam him into the ground. Yeah, that one. Skull Shaker. Alright, we bought it. That's some Devil May Cry in me coming out right now.
Icey arrives in the Moonlight Forest. In front of her waits Daha. Wait, where's the bridge?
Didn't it blow it up?
Right. Just keep following the arrow.
Yes, sir.
Icey jumps down. It seems like this is an old sewer.
As opposed to a new sewer. Well, I guess there is a new sewer. I don't know why I decided to be snippy at that. I have a feeling that most of the entertainment from this game will be just the story narrator. Oh, fuck me! I didn't see the little bumblebees! So I actually do have this spinny death move. Good to know. I'll just make him work. Are you the narrator, little floaty bumbly dude? I believe you are.
This place is littered with wreckage.
My wrecked enemies.
This place wasn't always a sewer. And who is to blame? Judas.
What is this thing floating on the chain? Can I hit you? No.
Icey jumps down into a giant cavern.
Well, if there's one thing that's handy about the narrator telling me what I'm about to do, or what I've just done, it's if I have any doubts that I can jump safely into a frickin' catacomb or pit that I can't see the bottom of. In some video games, you'd be a leap of faith there. But in this one, it's like, yep, no, that's what you're supposed to do. Which is actually kind of nice. Ah! You bitch! here we go. Those big ones are actually vaguely tough.
Icey follows the arrow through and passes through the gate.
It's so weird that it calls out the arrow. Oh good, I can double jump. I couldn't remember for a second.
Icey senses that the key to her escape is somewhere in front of her.
Isn't that how it always is in video games? There you go. See, I was looking at my money to see if those little rectangles are money. They are not. I will just float here in the air forever! Oh my fucking god! Oh, sweet Jesus! Okay, calm it down. Fuck you! Stop dunking me! I'm not a donut! Yes! Stop it! You big piece of shit! Who else wants some?
Icey discovers a special treasure chest.
Neat! What do I do with it? Oh, I attack it, Devil May Cry style.
A strange mark flashes across her eyes. Icey's dash ability has grown stronger.
Oh, I have 5 charges of it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
She can probably even escape from this damned underground labyrinth.
I can?
Icey decides to immediately return to...
You at icey.me. Attempting to find the chosen one is as difficult as finding a needle in a haystack. My time is limited. Judas has tampered with the Necronomicon, of course, and has announced he intends to sacrifice his physical body to cast his self into the virtual world. His goal? Create a child of God. The chosen one, as planned, has been born. Press A to view details, B to close. So I need to go up into the main thing and then go up and over. Okay.
Although it's a sewer, this place seems as if it could be incredibly clean. If it weren't for the sewer.
Isn't that like saying this dirty room could be really clean if it weren't for all the dirt? Doesn't that almost go without saying?
Mm-hmm.
That looked cool. If I do say so myself.
What could cleanse this place?
Fire? Holy fire, even. Nah, I'll save it. Because I want to get that regen. Maybe I should have bought an ability. Gorger. Ow! No! 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 Oh! Let me out! Let me out! Let me out! Stop it! Oh my god! I'm being comboed to death! You piece of shit! Oh my god! Fuck you, you little eye! Oh, okay. So he's invincible. That's great. Oh my god! He reacts so quickly! Oh, bullshit. I was dashing away. Piece of shit, let go! I hit the dashy do. Give me health. Come on. He's actually not that difficult. Oh! Oh, he had two life bars. I should have realized that's what that times two meant. There we go. Oh, I couldn't see. Ah! I can only get in like three hits. I should know better by now. Oh, fuck! Piece of dog shit! Come here, you little fucking annoying bumblebee bastard! Oh, you pissant! I hit the dashy do. I didn't press the B button in time. I hate these little eyeballs. Fuck you! Oh, mistakes! Oh, piss off. I'm so low. My slashes went right through those bastards. Come here, you big bastard! Yes!
Ha-ha! Icey defeats Gorger and senses that the exit is just out. Icey arrives at an unnamed town. There is not a soul in sight.
Well, I'm buying the friggin' regeneration. We're stopping here, but I'm buying this. No, B. B, stop.
So Icey searches around the house for a trace of someone, a mark of some presence. It seems as if everyone has been wiped out. The culprit? Most likely Judas.
I'm gonna take it that this is like... I don't know when the last checkpoint is, though. I don't know. I guess I'll find out when I quit this here in a second. But yeah, that's Dunsky's for now. I think I want to play more of this. Because it reminds me of a lot of games I like. The running and stuff reminds me a lot of Mega Man X, which is probably at least in my top three game series of all time. I like how quick the dashy combat is. It is a little... It goes a little too far. Sometimes, like, the movements feel like are always a little past where I want them to be. That may just take time to get used to. But yeah, I think I'll definitely at least visit this once more to give it another good go. But, yeah, so far, the animations can be a little janky. Like, the fast ones, combat, look good. But if you're watching the slow ones, it looks like they just took an image and kind of warped bits together. Like, you know what I mean? You've probably seen the style that I'm talking about. But it looks like it should tax your system way harder than it actually does. So I'm impressed on that front. Like, the drawing is really good. So kudos to the artist. Yeah, I like it. If you like what you saw, please leave me a like, comment, subscribe below, hit that bell, know when more videos come out. Share a video with your friends, watch your other videos, you know the rest. Peace out, Girl Scout!